Like, you gotta make a very hardcore commitment to your customers, all right, and give them ability to kind of steer the direction of that process if they're going to succeed. But enough of my kind of thoughts and opinions. I actually kind of want to hear your guys' thoughts as far as, you know, what we're going to see going into this new norm, whenever the hell that happens. I'm not going to pretend like I know what date it is. I love how people are magically throwing dates out. They're like, oh, the second Tuesday of June will be back to normal. I don't know what the hell. Anyways,
I
Cole, I'll start with
don't
you.
know.
How do you see the new norm kind of progressing for us?
I think, I'm going to talk digital retailing for a minute. And obviously, I was kind of keen into that a moment ago. And I got a little bit of experience there because when I was with DealerTrack, we were just bringing in digital retailing to the Canadian market. And it's been a buzzword for quite some time. It's been a huge buzzword, but it hasn't been true until you can introduce finance. Wet signatures or versus, I mean, digital signatures versus wet and home delivery, it's not really being digital retailing yet. And I think what we're going to discover is by force of necessity, because our consumers right now are getting trained to buy online. Hey, most of us are Amazon shoppers and we buy things online. There's a huge part of the population that have never done that, or that's not the norm. Well, unfortunately, it's the norm now. You want groceries? You order them online and do a curbside pickup. You want something from Lowe's? You order online, you do a curbside pickup. And I think we're going to now train our population into expecting that type of experience from the dealers. And I think our dealers, as much as they want to be able to do that, things are going to have to change to help them do that.